Well, good evening, everyone. We are live from the campus of Wilmington High School. We have lacrosse tonight. We have the Country Day Indians, and they will be hosted by the Wilmington Cane. Tonight's lacrosse match will begin at 6 o'clock. We are on for our little pre-match extravaganza. Charlie's already broadcast it on Facebook. He's getting quite the aficionado there on Facebook, aren't you, Charlie?
Oh, I love Facebook.
I know, I can tell. But anyway, Charlie has a lot of time on his hands. What can we say? They've got the lights on tonight. We've got a little bit of haze. Obviously, we've had some weather, you think? Hey, I actually set an appointment to go down to the Cincinnati Eye Institute to get my the pre-consultation or whatever they do.
Cool.
So the ball is now rolling.
Do you have to get both eyes done or just one?
No, I'm going to have one done, and then I'm waiting until I turn 65, and I'll have the government pay for it like everybody else does.
Only one is bad then right now?
No, they're both bad.
Oh, are they really?
Yeah, they're both bad. One's probably a little worse than the other. But anyway, one I will pay for, one the government will pay for. Actually, you know, my Medicare, which I paid into, will pay for
right.
it. But any way you look at it, I will I'll fit this bill, and then we'll let Uncle Sam take care of my other eye.
And, spoken like a true Democrat, but that's all right.
Well, no, you know, if it was an entitlement, that would be different. But obviously, this is something that you pay into. It's like
right.
Social Security. That's like saying that.
If it's still there.
That's like saying that you shouldn't get your pension, Charlie, because you know you're a government
employee. I have paid into.
Doesn't matter. You shouldn't get it.
Oh, I shouldn't.
Here's our rosters coming.
All right, good deal. Hopefully, we have some starting lineups. See, we do have Country Days. Team, and looks like they got quite a few players. 1, 2, 3, 4,
right.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 players for a Country Day.
Yeah, now the Indians, their coach was pretty happy with how they've played this year, and obviously with a 9-2 record, I don't know exactly who they play, whether they're in obviously there's no real leagues in the sense that most of the teams right now, since it's a club sport rather than an official Ohio High School Athletic Association sanctioned event, as it will be next year. And then next year, of course, you know, there's that question about our league, because I have heard that the SCOL will remain intact even beyond next year,
right.
for the purpose of the sports like lacrosse that we don't have at other schools that are in this SBCC or SBAAC.
Yeah.
I wish they'd shorten that, just make it SBA or some student business.
It's a Southern Buckeye Athletic and Academic.
Yeah. But anyway, so
conference.
The SCOL will remain intact so that teams that have sports that the other teams in the new league they don't participate in, they'll be able to still be invited to play in the SCOL, and we may even invite some other schools once again that are in leagues where maybe they don't have lacrosse or they don't have girls golf. Thank you very much, Coach.
Or swimming.
Right, swimming. And East Clinton, as far as I know, in talking with Jim Marsh earlier this year, Jim said that East Clinton will be adding swimming, this coming this season. So
well, they were the only team in the SCOL that didn't have swimming.
Well, and if you look at some of the other schools, they didn't actually, they called them swim clubs. So
right.
they weren't actually, sanctioned.
Now, who's that? SCOL? Yeah, they were all swim teams.
Well, they called them clubs on the roster. So,
yeah, they were swim teams. No, yeah. they were.
They didn't go by schools. They went by clubs. So
not now. Greenfield goes by school.
Yeah. Well, Greenfield's got a pool, so that may be part of it.
Well, and the rest of them, I'm pretty sure they're all same part of the team. Right?
Well, I don't know why they'd call them clubs then. It wouldn't make any sense. You know, it's like a lacrosse club. The club is because it's, at this point, it's...
maybe that's just what they call swim. Maybe that's what
I would call it a swim team, just like I'd call any other
that's
team.
That's what we call ours, a Greenfield swim team.
Well, so. We don't care anyway. You're not going to be in the league anyway, so who cares about that? Oh, your daughter swims. I forgot. Yeah.
Right.
Little fish there. Yeah, and she's a good swimmer, right?
Yeah, she's not bad.
And we think
she'll
be,
eighth grader.
We think she'll be a great swimmer as she gets into high school, right?
No,
I don't have any starters. No starters, only starters for Wilmington. I've got theirs.
Yeah, you want the Wilmington starters? No, Country Day, we got his only roster that he's ever given anyone. They don't even announce them at their home games or matches. So anyway, But you're listening to CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports. I'm here with Charlie Hargrave and Roger the Dodger, our technical difficulty on the camera here. And yours truly adding some color. And obviously, I'm the only one with a sense of humor. Everyone
lots
else is kind of dry. But Charlie...
Who do you get that?
Charlie, I know you're getting old. You remembered that there was a... you had to detour around.
Right.
But you forgot it
in plenty of time.
Well, you did. You're always on time. I got to say, you're never late.
If I am, I always text. If I'm late, I text to let you know.
Right, so we can get someone else in here until you get here, right?
Well, just so you can handle it.
Yeah.
And when you get your eyes back, I could be even later at that point.
I don't think so. I like just what I do, which is this. Well, look at this. We've got someone coming up with a camera.
Oh, yeah.
This is Eddie.
So, well, that's good.
Somebody's waving at you, Rick. I don't know who it is.
Somewhere.
Down front there. Some little girl's waving up here. I think she's waving at the guys, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, I do attract a crowd, Charlie, just like you do with your Target uniform you got on.
I know. Wilmington's starters are Zane Stevens, Hunter Frazier, Mikey Clark, Josiah Kiter, Hayden Straley, Bryant Burgerford, Ridgedon Beam, Cody Cravens, Connor Barton. Connor Barton seems to be the scorer for this Wilmington club. And
at least he has Justice, in past events, right?
Yes, Justice Ferris also. Yeah, Connor Barton has kind of been the guy who makes things happen. Now, Zane Stevens, he will fire up some goals every once in a while. Wilmington just needs to be more aggressive, I think, in this sport. It seems like they're always on defense. They got to start pushing the ball up, make some offerings. Last game we had them, they were playing Butler County, and Butler County was. Butler County just killed Wilmington. Clinton Massey beat Wilmington, but it was a good game. And this is our third game we've done of lacrosse.
Or you can even, if you want to, you can even set up out. I don't know if it's going to rain.
Yeah, I've got some rain here. I'll check out over here. Thank you. Yeah.
Heck, just stay in the booth and set up right there where you're going. Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. But anyway, all right.
We've got the Country Day cameraman up here.
Right.
So, and we got...
He could be from ESPN. We don't know.
We have 6 minutes and 57 seconds here before we get going with this match. And if you're not familiar with lacrosse, we aren't that familiar with it either. But, they do start off like in hockey with a face-off. They have the
penalty. They did last week.
Well, they didn't last week because there was a penalty prior to the game.
Not everybody was on the field.
Right.
When
I don't
they were
think everybody
to.
Was on the field when they're supposed to be. So
but you know that for a fact, right?
And I would be willing to wager a small amount of money on it.
What's a small amount of money? Like two cheeseburgers?
$50 or something like that.
Well, that's not small.
You're
a man of means.
No,
$50, you probably burn those, right?
That's how sure I was.
$50?
Teachers make more money.
Yeah. Teachers do make more money.
It's not so much the 50. It's just it's more of my confidence in what I think happened.
Oh, okay. Well.
So we'll see. Now, if they don't face off tonight, I could maybe lost. But I think that's what happened last week, because if you remember, the Wilmington player ran out late. Matter of fact, that was I can tell you who it was. That was Connor. No, wait a minute, that's not right.
Now let's not point fingers if you don't know who it is.
No,
Charlie.
I'm looking for the boy's name on here.
We don't want you wrong twice in the same
42. That was Musler.
Musler.
Yeah, Musler went out late last week.
So you think that's why there was a penalty?
I really do.
And they turned the ball over to the other team, which is true. They did. Wilmington was on defense right off the bat.
Right, and I think that's what happened.
Well, we don't know for sure, but it might be something to find out.
We're not we're not lacrosse professionals at all. We do know about the crease. We do know, I guess the biggest thing we've learned is when the ball goes out of bounds on a shot, it's the closest person to that ball, that team gets the ball back.
In the end zone when they're making a shot.
Well,
on the side.
Right now, if it's a pass and it goes out of bounds, then it goes back to the other team like basketball. But if it's a shot, whoever's closest to it where that ball goes out at, they get the ball back.
So then what do we think they're doing out there right now? So they only have three from each team out there
today.
Having
some kind of meeting with the captains.
Hmm. But all team members that start will be out there, all 10 on each side.
That's what they've done the last two games.
All right, okay.
They're doing some kind of coin toss.
Well, it's probably to decide who defends who, you know, yeah. Which side?
And they do switch every quarter.
Roger's got the coin.
So Wilmington's going to be heading this way. And
well, what is that, Charlie? Now, no one can, they only
Okay, Wilmington's going to be heading toward the right side, or I guess you would call out the south goal. And Country A will be heading toward the north goal, to
the
our
north?
Left. The north, yes.
The north goal.
The north goal.
Is that
to
English?
The left, yes. I'm trying to think and do this at the same time.
Well, this is
Wilmington is in their Wilmington is in their all white unis with the orange trim, and they'll be going left or right as we start the game. And Country Day is in like a navy blue uni with white numbers, and they'll be going right to left.
Yeah, I like Country Day's uniforms, and their numbers stand out real well.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do, and that's going to be good because, you know, that's we don't know, but. Yeah, one thing they did, they put, I love it with some of these clubs because they'll put their numbers down in order, and it makes it real easy to find
right.
Who's out there.
Makes sense.
Neither one of these clubs have done that today, so it may take us a minute to
but
find
it. Now, Wilmington's coach actually handed me that printed-out roster for Country Day, and he said that he got it off their website, so that's probably why it's the way it is.
Yeah, but it's just nice when they go in numerical
Roger,
order.
Did we know that before this match was over, Charlie would be complaining about something? It was either the wind or the rain or the sleet or the rosters.
It's not really complaining. It's just saying it makes
Charlie's
it a lot
like,
easier.
What was that, Pigpen that had the cloud over his head all the time?
Listen to you.
Yeah.
Well, I do deserve this abuse.
Well, you show up, Charlie. That's
like, probably it.
We love you.
Oh, Butch, your
colleague
will be up here. Butch will be up here with you.
Yeah. What Troy
said.
Yeah, Troy told me that, too.
He called.
Yeah, Troy was on the phone when I first walked in here, and he was talking with him. So he was pretending to talk with him. But anyway,
Troy,
I don't know where Bruce has been. Bruce is missing in action.
You guys made him mad, I think.
We made him mad, Charlie?
Yeah, I didn't make him mad.
You've been the rude guy.
No, I like Bruce. Bruce, he's a good guy.
Yeah, okay.
He is. I didn't even know I had this link on there. Which profession was in your past life? Musician, okay.
You see what I said.
That means I'm getting ready to die.
No, did you
past life since I'm a musician?
You
now?
Put that on there. I thought that was
you. No, you know what? This app puts stuff like that on.
Did you see what I said?
Yeah, I just saw it. And I'm going to reply to it.
You're going to reply to it?
Yes.
You're a Chippendale, right?
You're a sick individual.
Charlie would have had to been like 145 if he was ever going to climb the pole and strip. So we know that would have never been his past. You probably were born more than 145.
I tell you what, I was pretty big when I was born, but not quite that big.
Well, we got about a minute and 20 seconds.
And I'm sure the people that are wanting to listen to lacrosse are going, thank goodness. Because they're tired of listening to us already.
Charlie, we make it interesting. We make it, and I haven't heard from Angie, so I don't know if the mayor of Greenfield is listening, but she normally is.
Yep.
And I got your reply to that Facebook post there. So.
Good. I'm glad you did. All right. Yep. We're getting close. Did you see that? I thought that was interesting.
Yes, I did.
Well, that was yours.
The one that posted
that. I stole it from you. That's
yes,
right.
You did. So I did see it, Charlie.
That is pretty neat, though, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Very interesting.
Talking about Trump, how he actually has won all 13 original colonies.
Right.
And now, who picked a running mate today?
Cruz.
Who did he pick for his running mate?
Carly.
That's good because that's going to hurt him more.
Well,
so that's
on
good.
My post, I just put a little too late, Ted.
Yeah, yeah, that's silly.
Yeah.
Now, if he'd have picked somebody strong, might have helped him. Yeah, like I tell you what, I know she's not going to do it, but I tell you, if I was running, I would try to go for Condoleezza Rice.
Yeah, well, she's not going to do it. She is teaching. She's happy to be teaching. She doesn't want to leave teaching. So
she's
like you,
she's
Charlie.
She's a smart.
She is a very smart woman. Yes.
Wilmington Hurricane.
We doing that. We do the Star Spangled Banner here.
Eventually.
Before we introduce our starting
lineup. Yep. Star Spangled Banner is going to happen, folks.
All right. So we're going to
be back in a minute.
Right. We'll be back just shortly. As soon as the Star Spangled Banner is over.
Tell you what, we have a cool
overcast
evening.
Well, actually, this is normal temperatures.
Number six, Will Brady.
Will Brady starting.
Number 18, Jake Mayhew. Number two, Kyle Bannerman.
Jake Mayhew.
Number five, Ian
Kyle Bannerman.
McInturf.
Ian McInturf starting.
Four, Jack Gardner.
Jack Gardner starting.
10, Noah Hess.
Noah Hess starting.
13, Thomas McTaggart.
Thomas McTaggart.
21, Daniel Nesbitt.
Nesbitt.
Number one, in goal, Jack Schiff.
Jack Schiff.
23, Henry Mayhew.
Henry Mayhew.
Schiff will be in goal, right?
Yep.
Man.
Now for Wilmington.
Number 25, Zane
Stevens.
Number 29, Hunter Frazier.
Hunter Frazier.
Number 31, Mikey Clark.
Mikey Clark.
Number 13, Josiah Kiter.
Josiah Kiter. Mikey Clark will be in goal, I believe.
Number 28,
Straley.
Burgerford.
Bryant Burgerford.
Number 15, Ridgedon Beam.
Ridgedon Beam.
Number 42,
Cody Cravens.
Number 14, Justice Ferris.
Justice Ferris.
Number 22, Connor Barton.
22, Connor Barton. He's the goalie. That's why we called his name last time. I'm trying to think who is their scorer, though.
So now all 10 from each team are on the field.
Must have been Zane Stevens was the scorer. Referee's going over the, I guess, just the ground rules, telling everybody to be a good sport. Don't hurt anybody.
The audio and video stream of the game will be available on demand tomorrow afternoon on the CampusNation.com website. Campus Nation is your home for high school and college.
Goalies bump fists, and they head to their they had their prospective goals. Like I said, Country Day will be going right to left. Wilmington will be going left to right.
And we're ready for some lacrosse. This is the third or fourth match.
Okay, they must flip the coin, so I might have lost my 50 earlier.
Yeah,
so,
where are you taking us out to eat tonight, Charlie? Roger, we're going to B-dubs.
I thought the first game, though, didn't they face off? We didn't?
Yes, they. You know, I don't know whether it's a choice or how they arrived
at
that.
They did a coin toss at the beginning of the game.
So obviously, there's no penalty, so...
Yeah. All right, well, we have... Cincinnati Country Day with the ball, and they're moving around, so I must have been wrong. There's something else we've learned, boys. The coin toss makes a difference.
Got a hard way.
No, I didn't bet. You said if.
Oh, see,
bet.
Listen to him.
Ifs are very big words. Huh?
See, look at that.
On goal already, number five, and it's a 1-0.
Well, that was quick.
McInturf, Ian McInturf.
Here you go, number five.
McInturf.
Ian McInturf.
Ian is a sort of a name that you would think would be like a lacrosse, you know, player.
So quickly, 1-0 at the 11:33 mark. Now we are going to face off, boys. So that's a little football in there with the coin toss and who got the ball first.
I'm ready for B.O.
Yeah, you can be ready for it all you want.
Yeah, Charlie's
here we go. Number six has it. Brady.
Oh, another one.
And wow, he throws it in that quick. He just takes it right down the field and throws it in. Oh boy, hope we're not in.
Number six for the Indians, Will
Brady. I hope we're not in for another
long
like we did last time. Oh, that was ugly.
Well, I mean, they are 9-2. That means they're pretty good.
2-0. Yeah, I'm glad I didn't bet. I guess I'd have been wrong.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Oh no,
would not be the first time.
No, I agree. Would not be the
just
first time.
Just ask your wife. Or your daughter.
Oh, yeah, even when I'm right, they say I'm wrong. So 2-0 quickly here. Too quick, in my opinion. Two to nothing. And we already have a timeout. Wilmington's got to go, hey, this game started already. So 11:25 mark, Brady scores. So we're less than a minute into this game, and it's 2-0 already. And we'll have another face-off. I tell you, that goal only took 8 seconds.
It was fast.
That was pretty quick. and lacrosse, you have to keep somebody, you have to keep four back on defense all the time, so that's why you don't see everybody running down the field.
And that's also like, unlike hockey, where you can pull the goalie if you're trying to score late, you can't, there's no point in doing it in lacrosse.
Wilmington has possession of the ball. They lose possession of the ball, stolen away from number six. And that's Brady, and here he comes. He's charging right up the middle. He's going to make a side shot, no good. He has it out on the left wing. He passes it to 21. That's Nesbitt. Nesbitt gets it down low behind the net now. Take Country Days moving the ball around pretty good. Bad throw there. Let's see who's going to pick it up here. Like I said, defenders can't cross the line there. None of these guys can cross the line. Number six tried to take another shot, but it was batted away. Three with the ball now. That's Pohl. He throws it over to number 23. Ball's thrown way up in the air at 18. 21 comes down with it for Country Day. He throws the ball.
Still in bounds.
Still in bounds. So Country Day with the ball, and they're charging the net, and they throw it in. Number 10.
That was a sneak from around back.
Number 10, Noah Hess.
Indian goal, number 10, Noah Hess.
Good-looking man there. Now, not that other guy.
Which one?
This one. This one.
You going to go live on Facebook now? You haven't done it yet. You need to do that.
Charlie, I'm live all the time.
3-0 here. 3-0 at 10:06 to go. Wilmington just got beat resoundingly the other day. Hopefully they won't fall into the same trap they did. But that other team was really good they played. And this team, 9-2, they're not too shabby either. Six has it. That is Brady. He passes off number 18. He's dancing around with the ball. Throws it behind the net to Hess. Hess gets the ball taken away. That ball's on the ground now. They're fighting for it.
So what we got going on here now?
Holding up the ball now.
Some kind of a turnover there. Wilmington had possession, but then they turned it right back over to Nesbitt. Errant pass there. Comes in. Wilmington player almost come in with it. Come up with it. Coming off the bench. Back out to Brady, number six. Katz has it. Back to Brady. Ball's on the ground. Brady gets it. Has it out here on the left wing.
Country Day, these Indians have some good ball handlers.
Yes.
I would say, in the matches that I've seen Wilmington play, that's probably the biggest difference that I see, is it seems like most of the teams that have come in here are very good at handling the ball, and Wilmington's a little sloppy, and I don't know if that's because of youth or they've definitely been outclassed when it comes to the actual passing and the ability to handle the ball.
Seems that way, yeah. I can't argue with you there. Number six has it. It's off to the right of the net.
Kind of errant there.
Wilmington, number four, picks it up. That's Straley. He loses it. Goes back to number 21. That is Nesbitt. Shot on goal. Goes back behind. And the ball is going to go to Wilmington.
Last week they got behind, and started getting frustrated, obviously.
Yep.
I guess you would when you're down by 10, scores or more. But I don't even know, as far as we know, there's no real run rule as there is in
12.
Sports. 12?
I know. I mean, it's if they're down 12, they just have the continuous clock. It's
right.
All like
yeah.
football.
Yeah.
shot on goal again by Country Day. No good. The ball's behind the net, and everybody's chasing after it. He's going to go back to Country Day.
Wilmington hasn't even been on the other side of the 50-yard line.
Not much, no. Nesbitt, he gets the ball over to Hess. Hess throws it to 21, right in front of the goal. That's Nesbitt, and that's his first goal of the night.
So that's at 7:21 in this first quarter. Each quarter is 12 minutes. We have a halftime. Halftime, I think, is 10 minutes. I don't know whether it's rainy or not. It looks like we've got a little bit of precipitation on the window there.
Yep, 4-0.
And, of course, one good thing about lacrosse, they play in just about everything. The only thing, you know,
it's obviously lightning. Right? Yeah. Lightning, even thunder, I think it'll stop.
Yeah,
it.
I think where there's thunder, there might be lightning. So they looks like we've got a couple cars along the road there watching the match.
Wilmington comes up with the ball. Number 29 of Wilmington.
I think they finally crossed midfield. Come on, guys.
Frazier has the ball for Wilmington. He throws it back behind the goal. Number 13. I think it's 13. I can't really tell.
No, loses it.
They lose it anyhow. It goes back over to Country Day. 24 has it. He tries to throw it underneath, but it's blocked by Wilmington. Ball's on the ground. Mad scramble for it. They throw it up in the air. No one knew where it was. Ball is just all around the front of the Wilmington goal. Number 3 has it. He takes a shot for Country Day. That's Connor Pohl, and it goes out of play. But they retain possession because they were closest to it on the shot. Ball's on the ground. They're throwing it up in the air tonight.
Yeah, I imagine that's by design, though.
Yeah, I think so. Number 32 for Wilmington, Muzzler comes out of there with it. We got offsides on Wilmington, so it's going to go back to Country Day.
So, other than the players that have to stay back, the person with the ball has to be the first person.
Oh, shot on goal, number 10, that's Hess. And that's his second goal of the game. That was he got it right in front of the crease there, and he laid it in there.
5 minutes, 47 seconds. Is that it?
5-0 already, folks. The Wilmington's had lacrosse for a while, haven't they?
They have. They've had for several years. Like I said, my daughter, when she was a senior, she wanted to play. So she's 28 now.
They're fighting for it. Wilmington looks like they're going to come out. Well, maybe they're going to come out with it.
I imagine Wilmington's had it for about 15 years.
Number 3 has it for Country Day. That's Connor Pohl. He's coming up straight up the gut. With the ball, he loses it. Ball's on the ground.
Still scrambling for it, but Wilmington comes up with it.
Alex Musler has it. Ball's on the ground. They do have it on the Country Day side of the field, at least. But then they lose it. Number 6, Brady, comes out with it. He misfires, but it's picked up by 23, Henry Mayhew. He has the ball. Throws up number 4, and he throws it right in the goal. Nice pass by Mayhew, and it was right in number 4. That's Nesbitt for his second. Or excuse me, that's another player here. That's Benendum.
Benendum with 4:53 remaining in this first quarter. They're up to 6-0 now.
Benendum. Is that how you say that? Benendum.
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 So you say potato, I'll say potato.
Potato, that's right. Mm-hmm. 6-0. And the face-off, again, Country Day comes out with it. That's Jenkins, Sam Jenkins. He's coming right down the middle of the field. I guess you'd call that like a fast break probably here. In
I would say, yeah.
And he still has it, and he throws a shot on goal, but it's blocked by Burton. 15 for Wilmington comes out with it. At least I think that's 15. Yeah, that's 15.
Oh, now what do we have? Going
Rich
back to the
beam.
Back Country Day?
Ball must went out bounce, and now Country Day has it. Number five for Country Day, that's McInturf. He scored the first goal of the game. Country Day does move the ball around well.
Yeah, and they handle it well, and I mean, that's half the battle.
15 has it, trying to drive toward the goal. He dishes it off to number 10, that's Hess.
Back behind the net.
Yeah, behind the net to Henry Mayhew. He takes it out in front over here to the left wing.
Looking for an opening. He sort of spins.
This is the number five, McInturf. McInturf throws toward the goal, but it's no good. Wide right. The goal's here, just to let me remind everybody, they're 6 foot tall by 6 foot wide.
See, they need someone like you there in front of the goal, Charlie.
Well, you notice they got the Wilmington. They've got the big boy under there. But doesn't make any difference. Number 15 now makes his first goal of the game.
So we're up to 7-0.
That's Adam Katz
at 3:22 remaining in the first quarter.
7-0. And what's interesting is we've had six different scores. That says something.
Really good.
When
you can spread the scoring around to all those different players, that obviously tells you you've got some depth.
Well, Massey, I mean, Massey had a pretty good lacrosse team, maybe Wilmington, but one guy really stood out for them.
Right.
This team is they're really good. Ball's on the ground. Number six comes out there with it. That's Brady. He dishes over number 18, throws it out of bounds, so the ball should go back to Wilmington, and it will. Must be raining. There's our trainer down there with the umbrella.
Mm-hmm.
Wilmington to bring the ball in. They get it over to Musler. He's having a little trouble holding it, but he has it now, and he's taking it up toward the Wilmington side of the field. Oh, he tried to pass it, but number three for Wilmington wasn't paying attention. That was Boldman.
Scooped up by Country Day.
Yeah, so heading back the other way quickly is number 22. 8 has it. He throws for the goal, and he makes the goal. Number 8, that's Retzios, Thomas Retzios.
2:40 remaining in this first quarter. Now 8-0.
Today, Country Day's ball number 8, Thomas Retzios.
8-0, folks. Yeah, Wilmington really has. They've only had it down on their end of the field like two or three times this whole first quarter. Ball's on the ground. Of course, Country Day comes up with it, but Wilmington gets the steal, but the ball's loose again on the ground, and Country Day has it. Number 18, he's got it on the left wing, dishes over to number 4, back there behind the net, over to number 3. He loses the ball on the ground, scooped up by number 21, that's Nesbitt. Ball's loose. Kind of scrambling for it. Ball still loose. Picked up by Australia, but then he loses it again to Hess. Hess gets it over to number 3 toward the front of the goal, and they back it way out. Number 21 has it, Nesbitt. He throws it down to number 10, Hess.
And I imagine they have set plays like they would in basketball where they're on a play, and they do their picks, and they back out.
Number 6 has it way out on top. That's Brady. He kind of seems like the captain of this team.
Playmaker, point guard.
Yeah, just the guy kind of runs the offense here. Nesbitt chasing the ball down on the loose ball. How much time we got left? Minute 24 left to go first quarter.
Yeah, it would certainly be interesting to see in this first quarter just how, you know, time of possession between Wilmington and Country Day, because it's had to have been out of 12 minutes. It's got to be at least 10 minutes Country Day.
I would say at least, and maybe more. Wilmington there has the ball on their end. They did for a second, and then they lost it. Number 22 has it, Aquino.
That's him.
He throws it toward the goal, and he scores also.
49.9 seconds remaining in this first quarter.
Aquino.
What number was that?
22.
It's now 9-0.
Right, Aquino.
This can get very ugly. You know, if you figured they'd have nine goals quarter.
Well, I mean, they will have a continuous clock, and I'm sure at some point, days like this, I would think that the Country A guys would.
Well, he's got a big team that he brought with him, so he could put in his subs.
Ball's on the ground for the faceoff. Brady comes out with it. He's heading right toward the goal. He takes a shot. It goes wide right. Goes out of play. But Country Day is the closest to it, so they will have the ball again. That's Benendra.
Yeah, one of the things that I would say is, you know, it's not like having a 30-point, you know, lead in basketball. Lacrosse is a fast sport, and you can score goals quickly, as we've witnessed. So, you know, you have to have a comfortable lead if you're going to turn it over to your subs.
Right. Wilmington has the ball. That is Straley. He loses it, and he lost it. Number 10 now has it for Country Day. That's Hess. He gets rid of it to number 3. Pass right in front of the goal to 18, and it's in. It's number 18.
6.2 seconds remaining.
Jake Mayhew.
We're now in double digits, 10-0.
And the impressive part about this, folks, is we've had 9 different people score. Only one person has scored 2 goals.
Well, seriously, it is.
And that's Hess.
It's looked effortless. I mean, they really, it's not like they're, really having to gruel out there to get their goals. It's really just very simple, you know, and it's, I guess you could say when you look at it, it's sort of like, I don't know if you were watching a ballet or something. They handle the ball well. They pass the ball well. Yep. And obviously they've controlled the ball probably 99% of the minutes, the percentage of minutes here.
We got a stop there by Wilmington. And we had one more last shot on goal there by, I believe that was by Brady. And it was stopped by Connor Barton that time. Yeah, it's at the end of one, it's 10-0 right here.
If you can't possess it, you can't score. So, I mean, obviously at this point, that's why we are seeing such a lopsided score. Country Day has managed to keep possession of the ball and be able to work it down for all those attempts.
Well, and they're aggressive.
Has Wilmington had an attempt on goal?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't even think that Wilmington has had an opportunity to even attempt a shot on goal.
Again, tomorrow night, folks, don't forget on talktv.us, tune in about 7 o'clock for Keep Calm and Chaz On. You're going to say, well, Chaz, we got the NFL draft on. Well, you can still watch the NFL draft and listen to us over your headphones.
We had the NFL draft. That's on our website.
And by the way, since the NFL draft's tomorrow night, we can report who's being drafted by who. So hang in there. We can help you out, too, with the NFL draft. So that's not a problem. Not a problem at all.
I was talking to Marty Bogart earlier today, and
did you tell him about East Clinton feeding us?
No, didn't say anything about East Clinton feeding us, but he was in Pittsburgh with Dylan, and they were in, obviously a basketball event, and I think they're going to Terre Haute, he said, this next weekend, so they're staying busy.
Oh, well, they've been in Pittsburgh, they've been in Chicago. Well, we're getting ready to start round 2, quarter number 2 here. And it's 10-0.
We actually have some people filling the stands right in front of us here.
Well,
the comfortable seats.
Well, and I think they may be trying. Maybe there's a little rain block there, possibly.
It's possible. You know, we have seen more accumulation on the windows. It's not like it's a steady rain, but it's probably, and it's cold, I would imagine.
Here we go, quarter number 2, the face-off's going on. Country Day comes out with it. That's Barton. He's charging right down the middle of the field. You know, he's going to take a shot. He does, but it's Walked.
And of course, in this quarter, we're going, Country Day's going left to right, Wilmington's going right to left.
Right.
On your radio dial.
Wilmington with the ball, number four, Hayden Straley. He loses it, though, to number 13, Taggart. And we're back going the other way for Country Day. We got the stick knocked out of his hand that time.
Yeah, a little bit of checking going on there.
But no harm, no foul, no blood, no foul in this sport, it seems like. Number five, McInturf, has it out on top. He gives it over to number three, Connor Pohl. Connor Pohl taking it around the right wing. He loses it but regains possession. Throws it back out to McInturf. Shot on goal is to the left, no good, by
trying
number 15.
Sort of side
Adam Katz. But Country Day will retain possession because they were the closest to the ball when it went out, which I think is just a very odd rule, but that's okay. Doesn't make any difference what I think.
Well,
to me, it just seems like an odd rule.
Consider the fact that if you were exchanging every time you had a miss like that, we'd be back up and down the field even worse.
That would be wonderful,
I think.
I think that'd be wonderful.
It makes me tired.
Because, you know, more people, you know, it gives the other team a little bit more of a chance. This is almost like make it, take it, almost. But if you miss it, you get to take it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's similar.
10-0 here, second quarter. Country Day, they're spending plenty of time holding on to the ball, working it around. Ball may go out of bounds here. Nope, it's saved by 15, Adam Katz.
Nope, kind of whistle.
I think Country Day called timeout. Their coach didn't. He's going to use this just for some teaching purposes, I think. He didn't like what he saw on how I think his team was moving around. So he's going to talk to him about that. You know, it's kind of hard to You got to be careful when you coach when you're up big like this, because yeah, you want to, you can work on things that maybe you wouldn't normally work on during the week, and you can work on trying to get some more people to score. But I tell you what, they've done wonderful.
They've got
nine different scorers, and it's only ten. It's 10-0, but nine different kids have scored.
And we're going to be back here to Alumni Field on Friday, same time. It'll be 5:45 with the match to begin at 6. We're going to have the Alter Knights in to play the Hurricane in lacrosse, and so we'll have your car show tomorrow on TalkTV.us, and we'll be right back here on Campus Nation for lacrosse on Friday evening.
10-0. I believe it's still going to be Country Day's ball, and it is.
Yeah, they called timeout with possession.
Katz has it way out on the left wing. Throws it over to number five, McInturf. They're working the ball around. There's four different people that's changed hands. Oh, look at this. We got a little rotation, a little circle rotation. Did you catch that, Rick?
Yeah. Looks like a tornado.
And now we're going the other way. I wonder if they're just playing a little stall ball here. What do you think?
I don't know.
Almost kind of reminds you of four corners in basketball. There they go the other way. So the coach called the timeout probably to install this. It looks like it's something they've practiced pretty well because they keep rotating the team members around. Wilmington's not putting a lot of high pressure on them. Pass underneath the
Sneak
middle.
Them in the middle there.
And
Wilmington has it.
Wilmington gets the ball back for a second.
Well, they still have it.
Ball
goes. For it.
Ball goes out of bounds. I believe it's going to be Wilmington's ball. Straley over there to handle it.
You know, once again, I'm surprised at the attendance that we have at these matches. We really had some surprising attendance, at least as far as what I would expect for, you know, lacrosse is probably one of the more obscure sports that are played, simply because, once again, it isn't really, at this point, a sanctioned sport. It's a club sport, but there's a lot of interest, and I know why, of course. We enjoy watching these matches.
Yeah. Kiter shoots on goal, and it's no good, just over to the left. I think that's going to stay with Wilmington, though. Right. Josiah Kiter had a nice shot there on goal. Just missed it on the left corner up high.
Probably one of the first on-goal shots of Wilmington.
That's the first goal shot they've had today. Yes, you're right. Kiter with the ball back. Gets there to Boldman. Boldman has the ball way out here on the left wing. He gets it back to Kiter. Kiter brings it way out on top and almost throws it away and does throw it away. Number 10, Hess has it, and they're going the other way.
Fast break.
Got a little fast break here, but he throws it away in the Wilmington's hands, and the Wilmington player loses it right in front of the Wilmington goal. Number 4, Benedum has it. He passes it to 18 right in front of the goal. The ball was thrown, but it looks like it's going to stay in bounds. Number 10 is going to catch up with it, Hess, and he has it way out here on the right side. Number 22 has it. He passes over to 4. That's Benedum. I'm in trouble with that one.
Easy for you to say, Charlie.
Yeah, I know.
Shot
on goal, and it's good. Number 10, Hess. And that's his third goal of the game.
It's been a little long coming compared to their first quarter of scoring.
I think that was done purposely.
Yeah, well, it is now 11-0. That was scored at 7-12 remaining in the second quarter in the first half.
Really, I mean, you know, Country Day's just scoring at will right now.
And that's true. Like I said, it looked like it was effortless as far as their play. They handled the ball so well, and they maintained possession. And who knows, they've probably had 20, 25 shots on goal.
Country Day Indians, 11. Wilmington Hurricanes, 0. And we have the face-off going. Brady comes out with it for Country Day. They're just passing the ball out around on the top. I'm wanting to see if they're going to do their circle again. Yep, here they go. Up, pass right to the middle, number 18, but he takes it back out. Hess has it over to number 3, Pole. 5 has it now. McInturf. Ball thrown. Might go out of bounds.
Coming out.
Nope. Number 10 saves it for Country Day. McInturf. Shot on goal. No good. And it goes way over the goalie's head.
Almost to the soccer goal.
Ball's brought in bounds real quick by Country Day. Another shot right there on goal. It goes out of bounds. That shot was put up by Jake Mayhew. Country Day with the ball again.
Looks like those fans came with some blankets or warmth.
Brady has the ball way out on the left wing. Let's see if they start their another shot on goal. That was way high by number 3, Connor Pohl. Maybe that's the goal, to try to get Connor Pohl to make a goal, since he hasn't made one yet.
And it rhymes.
It does. Mm. Poet didn't know it. Number 5, shot on goal, and it's good. McInturf, that's his second of the day, and that makes the score 12-0.
Goal number 5.
With 5:41 remaining in the first half.
So they have slowed it down a little bit. I mean, they scored 10 in the first half, and we're over halfway through the second half, and they've only put on 2. So
yeah, I don't think at this point they're threatened by any comebacks. So.
Yeah, they've got it up to 12, so they want to probably get the continuous clock so they can get back home to the Queen City tonight. Getting ready to face off is Brady. It looks like Curso.
Just a reminder.
Wilmington comes out with it for a second, but then Brady picks it up. He's heading the other way. Brady is. He takes a shot on goal, and it's
almost. Did he make it?
Yeah.
It's good.
He got it right in there, Bill.
Goal number six.
So all our video will be available tomorrow, probably around 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. And of course, the East Clinton Invitational, which we did last night, is on our site. It's probably progressed to HD quality now. When we first post,
no, that's 33 out there, isn't it?
Joiner.
Okay, they got him in the program here. It's 39. Joiner out there for the face-off. Sorry to interrupt you. Gotcha. I just had the wrong number. Go ahead. The HD quality?
Yep. Takes a while for it to process, even once we've posted it. So, you know, usually an hour within posting, we're up to the HD quality.
Joiner has it. He's going to try to go all the way. He's going to take a shot on goal himself. It's no good.
Close.
The goalie comes out of there, and he's running down with it. We haven't seen that in the first three games.
Look at that.
Number 11, Jenkins has it.
Going in for the kill.
Jenkins shoots at goal, but no good.
That was a lot of action there. And you're right. We've never seen a goalie come that far out of the goal.
Out of the crease. Now, the crease.
You know, like with the soccer players, they'll come out and kick it, you know. But
yeah. So, Country Day again with the ball. We'll see if they do their little circle thing. I think they try to lull the defense to sleep, then they cut somebody right in front of the goal and get the pass to them. Wilmington goalie comes up with it.
Good stop.
Gets it out to Musler. Musler, he gets moving. You won't be in front of him. He'll knock you over in a heartbeat. Pass over to Traley Joiner.
So we have a running clock, 13 to nothing.
Well, it wouldn't be till the second half, I don't think.
That's right. Yeah, you're right. Second half's when they started.
At least that's what I agree.
I think that's what we...
Ball's on the ground. The way we fight for it. Wilmington comes out of there with it. Number 25, Zane Stevens. He hasn't had the ball much tonight. Like he's actually
shot.
Their store.
Scores!
Scores!
Great!
Score by Stevens.
25, Zane Stevens.
That was good.
And the crowd goes nuts here in front of us.
He was at like the 30, 35-yard line out quite a distance.
30,
yeah. And shot it in.
So 13-1 now. At least Wilmington's not shut out. Last game they were shut out.
That's
so
right.
Maybe that'll give them a little life.
Well, let's hope. Start the rally. Put the rally caps on, Charlie.
13-1. Here comes the face-off again. Ball's knocked out. Wilmington's going to come across with the ball this time, too. That's Traley Joiner. He's maybe thinking about just going all the way with it
looks
himself.
Like
it. He's trashing through everybody. Loses the ball right in front of the goal, though, and we have something going on here.
Will that be our first penalty?
Maybe a slash.
Must be
no one's coming to kneel down, so it's just a change of possession penalty, if it's anything.
Oh. And that's true.
Number eight has it for Country Day.
We've had no penalties so far in this match.
No. Four has it for Wilmington. He gets it over to number 15, Ridgeden Beam, throws it way down the other way, and it's going to go out of bounds, so it's going to go back to Country Day.
So the Indians have the ball. 2 minutes and 43 seconds remaining in this first half of play.
13-1. Country Day with the ball. That's number 8. Precios, he's already got one goal today. Passes it to 23. They're working the ball around good. Ball goes behind the net, and it's on the ground. That no one has control of it yet.
Tripped.
Nothing called. Wilmington tries to come out with it, but then they lose it. They turn it right back over.
You know, Bruce was saying that his daughter does the stats for Wilmington. Can you imagine having to, I don't know if they track assists and things like that, but how would you keep the stats? As fast moving as this game is.
Goals, penalties, things of that nature. Number four, Straley comes out of it there with Wilmington. He tries to throw it down. It goes clear down to the goalie area. The goalie, he brings it way out for a country day. Has a nice long pass clear over the midfield mark to number 18, Jake Mayhew.
I would imagine they probably have some software or something that, you know, as far as making stats easier to keep. They do that with other sports.
I know. They probably do. I'm sure they do. Now, whether Wilmington uses it or not, that could be another story, too. Ball is thrown out of bounds again by Wilmington. Not real good ball control there. They need to make their passes a little shorter. I think that would work better for them. 13-1, a minute 15 left to go here in the first half. And the ball is thrown in.
Actually, it seems like the match has gone faster than...
Well, the second quarter, I mean, let's face it, I mean... Country Day was basically putting on a little stall. They probably held the ball at one time for a minute and a half. Ball's loose, clear down behind the Wilmington goal. They're fighting for it. They're pushing, shoving. No one's got control of it yet.
This is what I like. Look at that.
Number 20's trying to come out there with it, but Wilmington player number 45 denies him. That's Britton Kessler.
Country Day with the ball.
Turnover back to Wilmington. And here comes Straley. He's coming down quick. Trying to see if he can get in there before the defense can get down there. Pass to 13. Ball's on the ground right in front of the Country Day goal.
He goes back to pick it up.
Day,
the goal's
Country
open.
Day goal is open.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And a shot on goal at the last second there by Zane Stevens is no good. It's 13-1 at the end of the first half. Goals so far for Country Day. Hess has 3, McInturf has 2, Brady has 2, Nesbitt 1, Benedum 1, Katz 1, Recios 1, Aquino 1, and Jake Mayhew 1. For Wilmington, Zane Stevens has 1, and he has another couple. He has at least one more shot on goal, and I think. I think Uzziah Kiter also earlier had a shot on goal. So we got about 9:40 here until we start the third quarter. So Rick, what's up? Anything? What's going on the rest of the week?
Well, we got a car show tomorrow night on Talk TV. That'll begin around 7 o'clock, Charlie.
I'll be there. Heard of it? I'll be there. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. We got a couple announcements this morning.
Who are your guests?
My guest, Jim Green. Jim Green, he is NSRA state representative, and for those of you who don't know what NSRA means, that's the National Street Rod Association. He has been affiliated with them for years as a safety inspector, as a state rep, and so it'll be interesting to talk to him.
Is that your pet there?
No, that's kind of nasty, though, isn't it?
Jeez. Dead. Fly.
Then, I always get one that says, I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it or not, but we got John Girard III. He's the one that, I don't know if I can make it or not. He's coming from AutoZone. He's got a special announcement to make tomorrow night.
I thought you said you don't know whether he's coming or not.
Well, he's supposed to be.
All right.
He's supposed to be. He may have to take his lunch or something to come up, he said.
Oh, okay.
But he is the manager at the Wilmington AutoZone, and he's going to come up and talk to us about some of the deals and specials going out there. Plus, he has an announcement we're going to make, which involves free food, Rick.
So oh, wow. Just so that's you know. Your favorite thing,
that's
Charlie.
Right. The best kind of food is free food. Anyhow, and then I've got a Dave Hurst coming in. And Dave Hurst you know, Chaz's DJ service mainly is the car show stuff, but we do other things.
We do. Okay.
We do other things.
What do you do?
And, well, we play weddings, funerals, bar mitzvahs, whatever. But
I've been to a wedding before.
Dave Hurst, yes, you have.
I didn't get married either.
Dave Hurst will be there, and we're going to talk about something that's coming up in the fall, which is, we're going to make the announcement live tomorrow night and let everybody know what's happening there. It should be pretty neat.
He was Rick, I don't know.
But anyhow, it's 13-1 here. Well, yeah, Dave Hurst is going to be there. He is associated, to give you guys a little hint, with the horror attraction, the Halloween attraction, the haunted junkyard.
So is this something horrible that you're going to be announcing?
It's going to be cool.
Cool?
It's going to be cool. Cool. It's going to be spooky, too.
Spooky?
Spooky and cool.
And trophy for it.
And you make
no. It's not what you think. Even you don't know what's going on. Roger's alluding to our spooktacular, which that's not the announcement. Then we have another announcement that's going to happen tomorrow night, which is going to be pretty neat. We're hoping it's going to be a big event that may come to Clinton County for years to come. We'll see. I've had the indoor car show out at Roberts for now 7 years, and this thing has potential, but yeah, you don't know until you try. But we'll explain it to everybody tomorrow night, and I think a lot of people are going to get excited about it. There is some car involvement with it, but not a lot. And then who knows who may else show up. Steve Picone's going to come for the pit crew, I think.
Steve from New York?
Yep, New York Steve. He's coming. And, I thought about just having him and Jim Green talk. They are both Mopar nuts. They are, they have the Chrysler emblem tattooed on their butts. So And we may just talk a little Mopar tomorrow, some 340s, 360s, 318s. Yeah, those are all Mopar engines. And Jim Green has had, I tell you, he's had just a gallery of cars. He's probably had 25, 30 cars just since I've known him, and he's had some really, really nice stuff. So it's going to be fun to talk to him because he's one of those guys that will build them, from the ground up. Yeah, he kind of tends to like more of the street rod, the older car, the fat fenders. But he has some muscle cars also. So join us tomorrow night. Should be fun.
And we want to congratulate the Wilmington Track and Field boys and girls last night.
Did they win?
The guys placed third and the girls placed third.
Okay, who won? Do you know right offhand?
Well, I don't know whether London, obviously it wasn't the same team, boys and girls. No, Massey placed second, I think, in both.
Right.
So Wilmington was third in both, and Massey was, but I think, I don't know whether it was Fairfield and London, and I don't know whether it was boys or girls. If you listen to our right on our website there, if you listen, you'll find out the finals as far as the scores. And that was almost just shy under 3 hours. And of course, we had a delay, but of course, that's not, we were off the air during the delay. The delay was about 45 minutes, I think.
That's silly, isn't it? I had a funny picture on Facebook earlier, and it's got all kinds of comments, and 166 people have reacted to it. One person loved it. So who's the one person that loved it? Debbie Munzer Lane.
Probably your wife.
Nope. 140 likes, 25 laughing at it, and one loved it.
So next week, actually in May the 6th, we have lacrosse again, Cincinnati Hills Christian Academy. The Eagles will be in to play the Hurricane.
That's next Friday?
That is next Friday.
Now, you'll have to find somebody else for that because I've got a car show that night.
Do you? Okay.
Get Bruce.
Yeah, we'll get Bruce and Roger will be here.
Roger will probably be going with me.
We've got he doesn't want to. He doesn't like your car shows.
You may want to pick another day there.
Then the Winton Woods Warriors will be in Saturday for a doubleheader. That's a makeup from earlier in the year.
Is that the 7th?
That's the 7th.
Okay.
And then we've got on the 9th, which is the following Monday, we have the last lacrosse match that we will do. The Little Miami Panthers will be in here to play the Hurricane.
What's next week?
That's on the 9th.
I mean, is there nothing Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday?
Nothing scheduled Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
Wow.
So move your car show from Friday to
I'm just DJing
to one of those days. But we will have Talk TV on Thursday next week, of course, just like we have your car show tomorrow night.
And then next week, the following week after that, we're going to have to bump it back to 8:15. So.
You mean because you actually have real...
I have, my real cruise-ins. They start at Generations May 12th, I believe. Is the day on that May 12th, and then May 11th we have a cruise in starting at the VFW, and next Friday night, not this Friday, but next Friday night will be down at Hillsborough for their first Friday cruise in.
So just a lot of car shows going on.
Oh man, it's going to get fun here real soon.
Well, the good thing is that our schedule as far as Campus Nation will be winding down for the summer.
It's bad over.
And we'll be focusing on adding additional programming to TalkTV.us. Whitney Arrowwood will be in with her show. She will be, it'll be working it with Whitney, working out with Whitney.
I like working it.
Well, obviously, it's not your show, so Whitney will make the final decision.
She can name it whatever she wants.
That's right. But she will be working it with me to begin with. She's got the incredible opportunity to take my sculptured body and refine it even further. And so I will be her first subject. I'm not going to say victim because she's not going to kill me. She promises. I will be her first subject, and she will look my body over from head to toe and decide what needs to be tightened and what needs to be tucked. She will sculpt my body into, a sculpture of art.
Okay.
Does that sound about right, Roger? So Whitney,
don't kill him. That's all I ain't gonna say. Just don't kill him.
She promises that she will not kill me, but it may hurt a little. But she won't kill me, and I'm tough. I can take it, a little of it at least. Now that's probably true. I'll have to have a bottle of Aleve on hand constantly, but. That is for sure, because obviously there are muscles I don't even know I have. In fact, they're not muscles, but they will eventually be muscles, and they will probably they'll be burning, I guess you could say, for a while.
Well, 13-1 here at the half, and believe it or not, those 10 minutes just flew by because we only have 30 seconds.
We have interesting conversations
until the start of the third period of play here.
So maybe the Hurricane can put a rally on here and get back into this match.
We'll see, won't we?
It looks like the rain has subsided. We don't have any wetness on the windows. And all our troops down here in front of us, I think they've moved further back down to the seats closer to the action. And there is plenty of action. It's just been very little Wilmington action, mostly Country Day action.
Country Day is a machine, folks. I'd like to see this Country Day team play at Butler.
That's right.
Butler,
now, those County. Two teams, and they may have. We don't know who the two losses Country Day has, because they've lost twice, and so that would be a good match, and they're both down closer to that area, so it's very possible that they have competed against each other.
Yeah, I would almost bet that they have.
Here we go,
getting ready for the third period. Now in the third period, they do face off. That's kind of opposite of football. So just the one time, the coin flip must be for ball. Okay, Wilmington has the ball, and he was starting to head toward the wrong goal, but he figured it out real quick. Trey Joyner has it. He's heading right toward the goal quickly. He loses the ball. Yeah, he's tripped.
And that will be a penalty. That's our first penalty of the match.
Looks like number 3, Connor Pohl, will be coming to the side.
So Wilmington will be a man up.
1 minute penalty. I saw the referee used a finger there. 1 minute. So, yeah, Wilmington will have an extra man.
See if they can take advantage of the extra player on the field. Not actually an extra player, but...
an extra player.
Well, Country Day is one less.
Right.
It's not Wilmington is one extra.
Well, yeah, but they have one more at this point. There you go, instead of extra. How's that?
That's good, Charlie.
All right. Wilmington moving the ball around. Country A just trying to set back and clog up the
right. They just want to defend
shooting
right now.
Lanes.
Want to run out the minute.
Looks like trying to set a pick there for Zane Stevens, but he didn't take advantage of it. Stevens has it way out in the middle.
Wilmington's
see, they're not being aggressive.
Time.
Yeah, they're not being real aggressive. They get the ball underneath, and it's thrown away. But, yep, number six comes out of there. That's Brady, and they're heading back the other way.
Man's back up.
The 1 minute's back. Yeah, 1 minute's gone.
They're at full force. Country Day on the move.
Country Day with the ball. Let's see if they do the circle thing again. Yep, there you are. Looks like, no, maybe not. Looks like they're almost just playing a stall. They've got the ball way out on the left wing. Threw it behind his back. That was a pretty neat pass there by number five, McInturf. I haven't seen any of that in the game. We've seen him messing around on the side, passing behind her back. Country Day shot on goal by number three, and it's no good. That's
deflected.
Connor Pohl goes out of bounds, but it'll stay with Country Day. Brady has it. He's looking to shoot. He's driving to the goal, but then loses it.
Good defense.
Number five, McInturf has it. He still has it. He's heading toward the goal. Throws it behind his back. And Wilmington comes out of there with it. That's Muzzler. And he's a tank, folks. You don't want to get in his way.
Back to Country Day.
Yep. He throws it away, though. Hurts. It helps the Country Day Indians out. McInturf has it. Out on top. Spreading it out a little bit, or Country Day. Again, another pass behind the back. But it's taken by the goalie, Connor Barton.
Yeah,
34
for Wilmington. Coming down fast.
Do you guys know who 34 is? Because he's not on my list.
He's not even in a white uniform. He's got orange.
John Doe for Wilmington, number 34 with the ball.
I guess there's no penalties for not having the same uniform as everyone else.
He's got pretty much the same, just shorts. It'd probably be like softball or basketball when you have reserve players, same type of thing.
Oh, okay.
And remember, it's not a sanctioned sport really either.
Well, that's true. We don't know, how precise they are.
13 has it for Wilmington. I believe that's Kiter.
Back behind the goal. He falls down. I don't think he was actually tripped.
Number five comes out with it. That's McInturf. Throws it down the other way. Looks like Wilmington's got a chance to retain the possession, and they do. That's Zane Stewart. Zane Stewart, he passes it off. 33 Spin. With a shot. No good. It goes out of bounds. It's going to stay with Wilmington, though. That was Traley Joyner with a shot high above the goal. Kiter with it in the background behind the net.
See, Wilmington has seemed a little more aggressive in the beginning of this quarter play, and they've retained possession a little
Pick
more.
Pick set. Kiter has it again out here on the right wing. He gives it off to Joyner. Joyner has it way back behind the net. He's trying to bring it out in front. He gets it over to number 17 for Wilmington. That's Nick Whiting. Nick Whiting passes it over to number 29 of Wilmington, Hunter Frazier. He still has the ball.
Shot.
shot on goal goes out of bounds. And that ball is going to go back to Country Dave because Wilmington didn't have anybody back there. And the goalie went running after it, so he was closest to the ball. So smart play by the goalie there. Country J bringing the ball up, long pass. That's thrown. Oh, it should have been picked up by Wilmington, but number 10 has it right in front of the goal. It's blocked by Burton, and he has the ball. He almost loses it. He does lose it for a second, but number 22 of Wilmington gets it. Ball's on the ground. Bodies everywhere. Ball's on the ground. We had some people knocked down, but Wilmington comes out of there with John Doe for Wilmington. Number 8 has it, and he throws it out of bounds. It should go back to Wilmington. And it is. Way back behind the Wilmington goal. Traylee Joyner has it. He gets just knocked to the ground by a couple of the Country Day players. He gets the ball, though, comes back up with it. He tries to pass it, loses it. Ball's loose right here in front. It goes out of bounds. I think that's going to stay with to Wilmington. Yeah, the Country Day player knocked it out, so Wilmington has possession. Josiah Kider has it. Country Day coach is arguing about something. I don't know how you can argue about anything when it's 13-1. Unless maybe he thought his team was being manhandled a little bit too much down there. Thought maybe there should be an unnecessary roughness call or something. Ball goes out of bounds. Wilmington has it. Number 17 charging the goal, but he's defended well. He loses the ball, but regains it. So Wilmington with the ball. Ball thrown in. Poor pass. It was stolen by number 22, Aquino. And Brady has it. And the rain's starting to pick up again a little bit.
Yep, seeing it on the window.
Number 3 has it. Ball is thrown in by number 23 for the goal. Number 23, that's going to be his first goal of the day. That's Henry Mayhew.
Country Day goal by number 23, Henry Mayhew.
So it's now 14-1. Country Day Indians leading the Wilmington Hurricane.
And we're down to, that was at the 2:45 mark in the third quarter. So 14-1. Ten different scores so far. And the ball face-off, Wilmington gets it. Number 33, Joyner. He's thinking about taking a shot on his own. He tries to throw it in there, but it gets blocked away. Number 25, shot on goal, is blocked. It's going to stay with Wilmington, though. That was Zane Stevens with the shot. John Doe, Wilmington, passes it. Looks like it's going to go out of bounds, and the ball's going to go back to Country Day. Jack Gardner goes and picks it up. Jack Gardner throws it all the way down to number 3. That is Connor Pohl, he has it. He gives the ball off to number 4 behind the net. Ball's thrown out. Brady takes it. He passes it back to Pohl. Pohl takes it underneath. They give it to number four, and he shoots it in. Number four, that's Benendum, hits his second goal of the day. So it's 15-1 here with 50 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. And you may be going, wow, that quarter went fast. Its reason is because once it's a 12-goal lead, they have a continual clock.
Right. They don't stop.
So it's 15-1. And we're getting ready for the face-off. 30 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Face-off. They're still down on the ground fighting for it. Ball comes out. Number 10 of Country Day has it. That's Hess. Gets it over to number 18. They're looking to score. Shot on goal. It goes out of play, but it's going to stay with Country Day. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, and
that's the
end of the third quarter. 15-1. So it was, what, 13-1 going into the third quarter. So now it's just, they've only scored two goals that quarter. So it's 15-1 right now in favor of the Cincinnati Country Day Indians. So anything exciting going on there, Rick, on Facebook? I see you keep posting stuff.
Once again,
oh, just my usual rants.
Political stuff, mostly.
Sports Animal. Audio and video stream of the game will be available on demand tomorrow afternoon on CampusNation.com website. Campus Nation is your home for high school and college sports. Fast quarter.
It was a fast quarter, wasn't it? It's the kind you like.
Yeah.
Unless you're Wilmington.
Again, 15-1 here. We're getting ready to start the fourth quarter. Tomorrow night, don't forget, keep calm, Chaz on, 7 o'clock on Talk TV. And we'll also be bringing you the draft picks when we get it. You'll have to help me out with that, Rick, tomorrow night.
We
can...
had our draft. You don't really need to worry about what they really do because we probably have it almost 100% anyway on our website right now.
You think so?
Maybe other than Cleveland.
Okay, hot rod.
Yeah, she is going pretty fast, isn't she? She's having fun. She's getting her laps in. The trainer here, she got her, it's not a gator. What do they call those? It's like a gator.
It's a John Deere, isn't it?
It's orange.
Oh, it's not a John Deere then. So they've got two new flavors of Pop-Tarts, folks. A&W root beer flavor and orange crush flavor.
That's Roger right there. He's a root beer man.
Yeah.
I want to try some of these new M&M's. Have you seen them? The coffee chocolate M&M's? I
haven't seen those.
Yep, those look pretty daggone good. 15-1, here we go, starting into the fourth quarter. If you've not been to a lacrosse game, I encourage you to come out. I know they charge something to get in out here. What do they charge? You know right offhand? $5, huh?
$5. And you look at the crowd. Now, of course, do they give the students a discount? We don't
probably
know.
Student price is $3, I'd say.
But any way you look at it, it does have a good following. And
yep.
It is exciting. You know, even when you're down, as we are, 15-1, it's interesting. And they
fast-paced.
They get into it.
Country Day has the ball. They have a shot on goal, and it's good. Number three, that is Connor Pohl, and that is his first goal of the day.
Country Day goal, number three, Connor Pohl.
11 separate players have scored for Country Day. Hess has 3 goals, Benenum has 2, Brady has 2, McIntyre has 2, and everybody else has 1 that's scored so far today. So we're getting ready for the face-off. And that goal happened at approximately 11:30 in the first in the fourth quarter, excuse me. Number 10 has it. It's over number 5. Shot goes out of bounds. So So it's going to stay with Country Day. It's kind of blocked there by number 23 of Wilmington.
We'll give a shout out to Travis O'Connor. I haven't seen Travis or heard from him for a while, but I know he's out there. He's busy with all these tournaments as far as basketball.
Yeah, I talked to him today, as a matter of fact. He's supposed to be getting me some prices on some shirts.
Yeah, you are getting a little ratty looking. That big red shirt you got on there.
I love his shirt.
Looks like you're a Target guy.
Yeah, I know. I love his shirt. I thought I just got it the other day. I think I got it at the thrift store. $1.25. Can't beat it.
Thrift store?
Yeah, Washington Courthouse. Oh. High thrift.
Never heard of it.
Ball's lost, out of bounds. I don't know if they're going to call. I guess they're going to call that a shot. It didn't really look like much of a shot, but they're going to let Country Day retain possession. 10 minutes to go here in the final quarter. Shot on goal, and it's good. Number 15, Katz. That's his second goal of the day. So that makes it 17-1.
Goal number 15, Adam Katz.
Looks like we're getting a little bit more precipitation.
Just a little rain,
on
just
the window.
A little rain.
It's
not
really,
much.
And there's obviously no lightning or thunder or anything like that. So it's just a little spring shower.
Yeah, we definitely don't want a half-hour delay with this going on.
No.
17-1. I guess McLean didn't get their track meet in last night.
Didn't.
Ball's on the ground for the face-off.
Well, the meet last night, the Invitational, we got everything in, I think, but the last event.
Right. Number 10 has it. Hess, he's bringing the ball up. Gets it over to number 15, Katz. He saves it. It was going to go out of bounds. Number 4, Benenum, picks it up.
He's your favorite player, isn't he?
He's all right. I just wish I could say his name better.
Shot
ball out. Looks like it's going to go out, but the Wilmington player gets it knocked out of bounds by Country Day, but they give possession back to Country Day.
Why would they have done that?
Well, Wilmington was actually possessing the ball, I think. Oh, behind the back shot by number 5, McInturf, is no good, and he's like holding his head because he thought he had it. That's pretty neat. I just hope we're not doing that to show off. That's the only thing, because we haven't seen any kind of behind the back passes or shots until this game, and not really until they've been up a lot.
Yeah, I don't think that's it.
Yeah, I hope. I don't think it is either.
I mean, you know, it's like when a basketball player, you know, dribbles
slam
between
dunks.
The legs or behind. Yeah, I mean, you know, it adds
dunk.
Some interest to the game,
right.
And I don't see anything, you know, antagonistic about that.
Straley goes over and intercepts the pass, and he's heading down for Wilmington.
He's hustling.
Yep. Well, he's trying to beat the defense down there, and he holds it up. He gets it over to number 3, Jacob Boldman. Boldman passes it to number 25, Zane Stevens. Zane
shot.
Stevens, long shot. And the goalie gets it, and he throws it back down, and going back quickly the other way, number 23, Mayhew, Henry Mayhew. He gets it to 15.
Shot.
15, shot on goal. It goes way high, though, and out of bounds.
He likes those sidearm shots, you know,
yep.
Comes across.
Katz, he's got 2 goals today. Number 4 has it. Gets it into number 23. Back over to McInturf. McInturf, bring it way out high. Or excuse me, that's Brady, 6. Gives it to number 20. That's Goings, Chase Goings with the ball. He loses it, but then regains it. He's being guarded there by Traley Joyner. Traley Joyner trying to dish out some punishment on the young man. Traley Joyner's going to map. Ball's loose on the field. Who's going to end up with it? Looks like number 3 for Wilmington, Jacob Boldman. He has it. Yeah, ball's loose on the ground.
Still fighting for it.
Yeah, the ball's still loose. The goalie goes and gets it, and he's running out way away from the goal. He's got it almost out to midfield. That's definitely the farthest we've ever seen a goalie
yeah,
take.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Go out.
Yeah, he's going back.
But he throws the ball away, so it should go back to Wilmington. But balls out of danger in front of his net there.
Yeah, and you're right. That's very interesting that he would go that distance away from the goal. Of course, he's got the ball, so as long as he doesn't lose it, he's okay. If somebody would have picked it up, then it could have been an easy score.
Ball stolen by number 10 of Country Day. He passes over to 15. Shot on goal was stopped by Connor Barton. That was a nice steal by Noah Hess. Wilmington has the ball. They're heading back the other way. Number 17, Nick Whiting, has it. Nick Whiting brings it way back behind the goal. Pass is on the ground. And it's going to be picked up by Wilmington. That's picked up by Zane Stevens, Wilmington's only goal scorer today. One of only two or three that's taken a shot for Wilmington today.
They're hacking at him, trying to knock it loose. Shot!
And it's blocked. Good block by number one.
Here it goes again. Look at him. He's losing it.
Lost the ball that time.
See, that's dangerous.
But he got it back.
He's past the 50-yard line.
No offsides because they had so many defenders back. You got to keep four back. He's aggressive. That's Jack Schiff, the goalie. He's done a good job today. He's only let one goal go in, but hasn't had too many. He hasn't had to do much either. He's only had four or five shots on goal.
And maybe he was bored.
And he stopped a couple. Well, I'm sure he probably is.
Now, I would just wonder, as a goalie, I guess, could he go up and score a goal?
I don't know.
That's something we should find out.
I think as long as you have four back, you're okay.
Yeah, so that would really be interesting.
Number three has it. Shot on goal, and it's good. That's Connor Pohl. That's his second goal.
That was 353 remaining in this last quarter of play.
18-1.
I think that's the highest score Wilmington has had against it that we've done a home game.
I'd like to know who they've beat.
Xenia was one of the teams.
And Taylor.
Taylor?
Yeah.
Xenia and Taylor. Okay. All right.
So we're ready for a face-off again.
Some kind of a penalty there on
Wilmington
Country Day. They must have tried to go for the ball too early on the
spin in front. Spin again.
33 takes it all the way down in front of the goal. And
tried shooting in even as he was falling.
The goalie just fires it down the other way. Nice pass to number 18. Pass back to number 10. There's no over and back because in basketball that would have been an over and back. Number 4 with the ball. That's Benendum. Over to number 6. He takes a shot. No good. Over the head of the goalie. Brady. 2 minutes, 33 seconds to go here from Alumni Field. 18-1. The Indians of Cincinnati Country Day are just putting it on the Hurricane tonight.
Yep, that would be an understatement.
It was 13-1 at halftime, so they have kind of called off the dogs a little bit. Passing to number 18, and he puts a little goal in there, Jake Mayhew. That's his second goal. Says 19-1 at about the 210 mark.
Number
18,
Jake Mayhew.
19-1, folks.
Well, I mean, they were on pace to make it 40.
Oh, I know.
So,
yeah.
So they have called it off.
But I hate to see a team get beat like this.
Well, it is lacrosse, and there's a lot of scoring in lacrosse, so. And especially
the last two games, Wilmington's had it rough, though. Yeah. I mean, I don't care who you are. I hate to see a team get beat that bad. I'd like to see a nice close game, like 5-4 or 10-9, something like that. Well, we got a penalty here with 1:15.
Only the second penalty of the match.
Well, then they're going to let the play continue, and then the penalty will be called when the next stoppage of play is. Number 4 has the ball. He gets it out to number 6, Brady. And there may not be a stop.
I was going to say, as well as they play.
the game.
We're in the last seconds of play.
Brady's getting beat on there by
Whistle blow.
Well, they keep that clock running.
It does.
Some kind of a turnover here. I'm not sure what happened there. I guess now we're just doing the penalty. I didn't see the stoppage in play, but 23 is heading to the bench. That's Michael Presso. He's going to be out for the remainder of this game.
Right, we only have 25 seconds.
Yeah. Number 20 is going to pick it up.
Fans are starting to head for the exits.
Chase Goings. He's charging the net. He gets knocked down pretty hard by number 33 of Wilmington. That is Traley Joyner. So a lot of these guys are pretty sore after
breakaway.
This game.
Yeah, I would imagine. You probably do get beat up.
Number 8, Rissios has it for Cincinnati Country Day, and that's the ball game.
Match.
All right, well.
19-1 in this lacrosse match, as Roger corrects me.
Right.
19-1. Scores.
This Friday night.
Hess, 3. McIntyre, 2. Benenum, 2. Katz, 2. Jake Mayhew, 2. Connor Pohl, 2. Henry Mayhew, 1. Aquino, 1. Rissios, 1. Nesbitt, 1. And for Wilmington, Zane Stevens scores the lone goal. He had two or three shots on goal, and so did Kiter had at least one shot on goal. We're back here again Friday night.
That's
hopefully,
right.
Hopefully Kane can get out of this slump they're in.
The older Knights will be in, and that will be a we'll start our broadcast at 5:45 with the match to start at 6. And in the meantime, you can always tune in tomorrow night for Charlie's Car Show, and that'll be starting at 7 o'clock from Generations Pizza, or even come out and buy us some pizza.
There you go. That'd be better.
That would be better.
If you'd like to see the first three shows, it's on talktv.us. Plus, there's a couple other shows on there, The Razor's Edge. It's a political show, and then there's a couple sports shows
Sports Planet.
So.
Yeah, we've got the NFL draft that's up there, and it'll be interesting to see how close they were to the actual NFL draft tomorrow night.
Yep.
So, for Charlie Hargrave, for Roger Thompson, this is Rick Phillips. For CampusNation.com, the sports animal, your home for high school and college sports. Good night, everybody, and go Kane.